feature events. First class on the speedway will be the beginners, and they will begin the program. That's appropriate. Beginners will begin the program. So your pole setter is the 03, and that's Carter Tressler. And alongside Carter Tressler is Carter Petrowski in the number 20C. And it's the number 18, making up the second row, 18 of Trap Robinson. And alongside him, the 12 of Austin Tressler. Bringing up the rear is the number 9 of Carter, the 9 of Faith Klinger. They come to the flag stand and green flag waves, and we got them tied up already. Well, it looks like the 20C of Carter Petrowski trying to get to the inside. Problem was, the 03 was already there. So they got tangled up, and we don't have a start. So we'll line them up over in turn 3 and try it again. It'll be single file this time because they get a one-shot deal with the double file start. One-shot deal, double file, and then we'll go single. Shouldn't have that problem this time. Up in turn 3 there, set, getting the field reset. This is take 2. Only thing is single file this time as they come down to the flag stand. Alright, we'll watch them as they head down the backstretch. Under green, they're side by side for the lead. Just like that, the 20C will jump out in front. That's Carter Petrowski. With the lead. Running second, the 03 of Carter Tressler. Tressler picked up the win in the heat race, but Petrowski was right on him at the checkered flag. Now, Petrowski has the lead in the feature event. Did not get over, kept it on all four. four wheels. He had some pretty good speed build up there going into turn three, and it's fortunate that he didn't get upside down. So that'll bring out the yellow, and it'll get things reset. On the speedway. again a little later here. We do have a winner on the money that's been collected. So we have a winner on the money. Here we go. Looking for green flag, close 375. And there it is. Okay, we'll take it through turn one and two. Down the box. Let's look out off of turn two. We got him in the tires. The tires go flying over in turn number two. Number 12 getting into the tires there. That would be Chase Hendrick. Now we'll see if he's able to continue. He hit pretty hard. We got 5 minutes burned up of this race here already. Well, I think we'll be all right. We still got 10 minutes to go. So Colby Walter with the lead. So we still got another one, 340-898, and a pit pass, 340-935, 340-0898, and 0935. Starter Brian Shutt signaling, one more lap, boys, be ready to go next time out of turn number four. Okay, we're going to watch them as they come out of turn number four on the inside of the cone. Everybody gets through. Okay, we'll watch them in turn one and two. Green flag back on the speedway. And they streak down the back stretch. Your leader, Colby Walter, in the number 96. Right behind him, the 12K. Dylan Starr running third. Starr looking as they come. That's her video machine. Working on two, has two wins here the last 2 weeks. Trying to pick up the third and three in a row here. Evan Madigan. Alongside him, the number 69. And that's Kyle Rapp. Kyle actually kind of part of the team there with Madigan. Helps out from time to time. So Kyle starting alongside his buddy. Then, going back to the second row, we got the 24 of Tyson Thomas, a past winner here. And then it's the 61 of Cruz Kepner. Taking a break from the 305 sprint car. Finds himself starting fourth here in the Predator Cup. Now, if you remember a few weeks back here, Cruz Kepner did win the 340 King of the Mountain race. Predator. So you gotta keep your eyes on that 61 too. He could be a threat. Any one of these junk guys, really, any one of them can win it. The 02 of Corbin Livey has a lot of wins at Predator. He's back there, along with Cody Zimmerman giving him a shot tonight. In the 17. Then it's the 54 of Robert Mason, the 15 of Derek Fry. We're looking for green down the front stretch. Well, gotta get them front rows side by side. Pole setter, you know, should be at least in the lead when the green comes out, you would think. But we'll give it another shot. See if they can get it going this time, otherwise they'll go to single foul. Here we go. Green flag waves. Kyle Rapp gets the jump here. He'll be your leader as they head down the backstretch. Kyle Rapp, your leader. Evan Madigan gets caught on the outside and trying to fight his way back to second. Grab your leader in that number 60, or, yeah. In that number 69, and now moving up and taking over the lead, the 02. And that's Corbin Livey, Livey your leader now. So we've had three different leaders here. Livey, Rapp, and Madigan as they head to turn three. And it's Cruz Kepner. Madigan looking to the inside of the 69. Madigan will move up to second. He takes the 61 of Kepner with him. Kyle Rapp back to fourth now. Livey with the lead. Madigan running second, running third is Kepner. Everybody's staying in tow here. Nobody getting away so far. Livey with a comfortable lead as he heads down the backstretch. Nobody pressuring him right now. Madigan trying to close the gap. Keeping a close eye on the leaders here. Now Livey with the lead. Madigan runs second. Livey hasn't been running Predator lately. He parked that thing for quite a few weeks. Here comes Madigan now on the inside. Madigan's threatening. And he will take over the lead as they head down the backstretch. Just as Madigan. Can he hang on to it? Livy gets a little high up out of the groove. And Madigan pulls away just that quickly. Evan Madigan trying to get three in a row here. He won the last 2 weeks. And he looks strong here tonight. Hit that Strasser video machine. Yeah. Madigan. Then the 02 of Livy. Then the 69 of Twile Rapp. And then the number 61 of Cruz Kempner. Kempner now looking at the back of the number 69. Kempner wants to move up. Laps beginning to tick away. Livy's still back there. Here comes the 61 of Cruz Kempner now. He moves up to third. Kyle Rapp has dropped back to fourth now. Kid Smooth, Madigan. They call him Kid Smooth. And that's why, because he's a smooth operator in that number 48. Here he comes now. Come up on line traffic, gets by easily. So does the 02 and the 69, or 1 and the 69. No problem there. They're coming around now. We're getting down near the end, folks. Halfway, anyway. I believe it is an extended race. Madigan continues to lead. Cruz Kempner now actually closing the gap on the 02. Kempner begins the game on the 02. Right on his rear bumper now. Kempner in the 61, he's up beside the 02, and he gets by, takes over that second spot. Here comes Kempner. Madigan actually began to pull away a little bit under that while they were battling for second. Madigan gets a little more breathing room. He's been fast here at Penn Street. Came here to win the cup tonight. Traveled all the way from Virginia. Here we go. Not sure how many laps are in, but it's got to be getting down near the end now. At the halfway sign a little while ago. Madigan coming up on more lap traffic. Actually the fourth annual Predator Cup. Well, traffic on the speedway for your leader, but he gets by no problem on the backstretch. Now, Kempner will have to deal with the last traffic. Turn four, more last traffic on the speedway. For your leaders. Oh, that was close. I'll tell you what, Montrevi can play a major role in the outcome. It can. seen it before. Out of turn four, your leader continues to be Evan Madigan. Cruz has closed the gap a little bit here. Kepner closing in. I'm sure Madigan's wondering where that two-lap sign is. Continues to lead down the backstretch. Tension's one thing, pass is a whole other deal. There's a five to go. Five to go now. I'll tell you what, Kepner's not back there that far. He could easily make a bid for the lead here. Kepner, a very experienced driver, lots of wins there at Penn Street, and now we get a yellow. Right here in front of the flag stand. Nate in the 54 brings us yellow. Love Nate. But now we're going to find out. We got like four laps to go. Watching both the fathers here. Mike's down there on the rail. Phil's up there in the tower. Watching them both, and they're watching close. I'm a big fan of Cruz Kepner, I gotta tell ya. We can't win it. I'd be just as happy to see him win it. Here we go. Green flag back on the speedway. We got like four laps remaining. Both the leaders are pretty equal, although Kepner has closed it up some. He's right on the back bumper now of Cruz of Evan Madigan. Madigan's gonna have to watch that inside. Kepner right there. They get the two to go. Two to go now. Evan Madigan under pressure here. Look out, we got a battle for second. Oh, we got trouble over here on the backstretch. They were coming for the white, and we got them upside down. Didn't even see that. I'm watching the leaders. Over Cruz Kepner, we're going to find out. He had a comfortable lead at one point, but it's gone away under the yellow and then the red. Then white flag had been over, but it wasn't. It was two to go. Well, the yellow lights are out. We're waiting for green, and here it goes. We got two laps to go, so it'll be green, then the white, and then the checkered. White flag coming out. Evan Madigan trying to hang on, but Cruz Kepner gets right through there and makes the pass. Out of turn four. Tough break for Madigan, but Cruz Kepner picks up the win, and we still got him rubbing and scrapping at the finish line. We'll be right back. first will finish third, and we, that's the lineup order, the 18, the 7, and the 30, and that's the way they are on the track, so we'll look for green out of turn 4, hopefully. crazy. I couldn't tell. All right, green flag waves, and we are underway. Start the clock. Trevor's up, your leader, on a turn number four, coming down to complete lap number one. He won't front second. And that's the number 29. That is Madison Musser running third. Trade Berkheimer, your pole setter in the 31. out of turn four, double foul, 10 lap Thursday, 15 lap distance, three flyways. Probably the reason they were confused. They went from double to single. Here we go, out of turn four. Green flag waves, we'll start the clock. Well, the 31, your leader. Caught the end of that. Driver is still in that. That's a cage cart, so. Heads up, we got that four-wheeler coming across there. Here we go, green flag back on the speedway. Langer changes to number 31. Wertheimer still leads, Wagner. They got 7 minutes to go. Should be able to last one, so they got a couple of laps to go. Come around and be looking for the white this time, I think. Yep, white line, one more lap to go now. He's pulling away. Bergheimer. He's got him covered here tonight. And rookie two. Checkered flag waves. He'll pick up the win. Wagner will take second. Finishing third is the 38.
Be warm.
drive a brown. Then the 4 of Matt Myers alongside brown in the 55. And it's the 98, the 2, the 17, the 24, and the 18. We're looking for green. No, we're not going to get a green. 2 scrambled up. Predator Jr. going here. They're going for a cup, fans. Out of turn number 4. We'll watch them as they come to the green flag. Side by side into turn 1. Coming around to complete lap number 1. Wagner, your leader. Followed by the 36. Of Klein. They head down the back stretch. Moving up through the field in the 23. Carissa Springer, a good showing in the heat, but she is falling back here in the feature. Wagner way out in front in that 0. He has nobody racing with him right now. 36 runs second. That's Tyler Klein. So Wagner on a hunt for the cup here. Here comes the 23.
Thank you.
So we're watching them here. Wagner with a big lead. That'll all go by the boards.
Keep your head up.
Jackson Thomas riding in that second spot. He'll have an opportunity here. Let's see if he can do anything with it. Green flag back on the speedway. Thomas is fast. But Wagner got out there and got a big lead. And now look at Thomas go. He wants that cup. Jackson Thomas, your new leader, as they come to the flag stand now. But he's giving that inside way up. He better be careful. He's going to lose the lead. Can't be sticking way out there. You got to protect that inside a little bit. We got him spinning up in turn three and four. Another spinner. Could be Thomas is just fast enough. He can run wherever he wants. He's fast. I mean, I saw him coming, but I don't know if he'd have ever caught Wagner. But boy, the yellow helped him. So they'll line up again, bumper to bumper. By the way, the 50-50 tonight was won, and it was $177. So, you know, that's a good payday for someone. Yeah, that'll buy you a couple tanks of gas, actually. Yes. Unless you got a truck or something big, then it might not. Brown stopping here now on the front stretch. Waving to the crowd there. I don't know what that was. There we got Jackson Thomas, your leader, right behind him. Number 18. Garrison Zook. Zook's also fast. As I said earlier, here comes Zook up the inside. He goes by. Zook just goes by the leader like he was chained to a post. What the heck? Yeah. Here we go, Garrison Zook now taking the lead. That's the kind of thing that makes the tech man set up and take notice. Man, these two out in front are fast. I'm telling you, if you can run that well against Wagner, you're going somewhere. You're motivating. Well, they're at the halfway sign. They got half the time expired also. 7 or 8 laps in, and they still got 7 or 8 minutes to go here. Predator Junior Cup on the line here. And right now, it looks like the 18. Garrison Zook wants it the most. Springer now way off the pace in the 48. Looking like he's going to pull in. Hand in the air. So evidently, something to miss on the 48. Started out good. Not ending up well. good race here for the lead out of turn number four. Garrison Cook hanging on, but Jackson Thomas is right there. They're both well out in front of Wagner, who runs all alone at third. Doesn't hit anything. No bite up there. All right, we'll see if we can get green here. We'll get right back to it. Your leader, 11B, Jerry Luzon. One of the Fight Club members. Carter Hauser runs a tight second right on Boozle's bumper as they come down to the flag stand. Carter Hauser been running pretty good this year. He's got some wins, I think, at Hunterstown. He looks to the inside of Boozle, but can't quite get there. Just a little push from your third place runner. That might be all he needed. Coming down the front stretch, he's looking to the inside. No, can't do it. With Boozle, gonna have to keep his foot in it. Boozle under a lot of pressure, out of turn four, down the front stretch. Here comes Carter Hauser. And now the three is in there. The three of Brad Keister. He's in the hunt. Keister's there. The front three under a blanket as they come to the flying stand. Keister looking to the inside now. He's going to move up. Keister missed a second. Does he have anything from Boozle? Man, he's looking fast out of turn four coming down the front stretch. Keister in that three. He is right there. He has the horsepower, folks. If he can get him set up out of turn four. Make that move to the inside. See if he goes for it this time. Out of turn four, he's got Hauser all over him. Fishtailing out of turn four. Like this. Looks like the three, a little bit loose. Think like the hang out at the back end hangs out, and then he got 2 laps to go.
Spot. He leans to the inside as he goes through the corners.
13H, and then the number 19 of Tommy Thompson. Cage clone red, you should be on the grid. Cage clone red, you should be on the grid. That's Cash Livey and his fellow competitors. We're getting a 2-lap tie on your leader, the 97 of Zach Gerber. Zach's gonna encounter some lap traffic here next time around. Comes around and gets a white flag. Zach gets by easily, no problem with the lap traffic. Coming around now. Gonna take the checkered flag. Zach Gerber will see your... Okay, here we go. Let's try it again. Take two. This time, the 7 of Bingaman takes him to turns 1 and 2, but loses the lead down the backstretch. Bingaman, real good in the heat race, but now looking at the back of the feature, your leader is the 42 of Libby. Cash Libby with the lead. You go back, whether you stop or not, doesn't matter. It's for you. They brought it out on your account. Tough break for Cash Livey, a big lead. They're burning up the clock here. About half their time used up here. We'll watch them out of turn 4. Hopefully we can get back to it here. Green flag waves. We're underway. 7 minutes left. See if Cash can get back up there. Trying to make a move here from the rear. That's tough. It's tough to come back. 5 ain't making it any easier for him. That's for sure. Here comes your number 7, still battling, trying to get the lead. Here we go, off turn 4, and the leader spins out right in front of the 7. Oh boy. Out of turn 4. Green flag back on the speedway. Bingaman will resume as your leader. Running second to five. That's Jackson Busser. Climbing back up to third. Halfway. Minutes left, and we got another yellow. Green flag back to the speedway. We're down to 4 minutes left here, so they've burned up a lot of time with these spin outs. And then the realignment, that takes time. Yellow. There goes a wheel. Well, we got a wheel off of one of them. That must be a race front off the five. The balance plugs or what? They don't want to fire, so we'll watch them out of turn. Four, tough break for Renard. He'll be a spectator. Green flag back on the speedway. And here comes Lakewood in the jump. And they head to turn one down, so back stretch to turn. Must be using the force. Well, we're gonna go green again. Hopefully we can get some laps in here. As I said that, Woods can retain the lead to 527. The house. then she was way out there in the 17th.
Coming out, and
all summer, really. Colby Wohler hanging on to the back end of that machine, though. He's hanging in there. He's second, and Dylan Starr has also been good here this year. Price of these motors just kept going up and up and up. I mean, they're just rockets compared to what they were when they started out. Things are cranking close to 7,000 RPMs now. Some of them are cranking 7. Just teasing Raymond Weiser here a little bit. Man, I miss your brother. I wish he was here.
I don't.
I know you don't. Someday you'll appreciate you had a brother. All right, here we go. Green flag back on the speedway. I've got Tommy Hetrick up here. He's beat. He says he's tired. He's had enough of it. We're gonna go this last one here. What do you think about being grid man, Tommy?
My back is killing me.
Said his back's killing him. He don't have no voice. Poor guy. Well, Bowersock, he's got command of this race so far. Wayne Ulrich runs second. Coming down to here now, Smith running third is the number 54. That's Robert Nace. He's getting pressure from the 61 of Chris Kreider. That's a new ride, I think, for Kreider. Formerly a Trevitz cart. Seen that thing racing Fields Group quite a bit. Nice looking go-kart. Boy, I'll tell you what, they look nice when they're out in front, like that 72 right now. He is really putting them to sleep here in Predator 410. Heck of a race from second on back. Diff really going crazy here. They're all chained together as they come down the front stretch. Here comes the 61 now on the inside. He's going to move into that third spot. He might even get second out of it here. He was trying. See if he comes down the hill. Nope. It's going to be hard to put that move on the 77 because he knows about that. He knows it's downhill coming down the front stretch. See how he goes down there? Yeah. The 9 was even in the hunt there.
Yeah.
Yeah, the 9. Yes, sir. That's Joshua Master. That's Raymond's other car. I'm telling you, that 4 are welded together. Kreider moves up and takes over that second spot from Wayne Ulrich. He may be able to drive away from those other three. Talk about driving away. Look at this leader here, 72. He is gone. Got a half a track lead. Kreider continues to hold him off in that second spot. He's actually getting a little bit of daylight. He's putting a gap between himself and third place, Wayne Ulrich. He's going 40 laps here. That's a lot of laps. Hey, look here coming. Right up the inside. Raymond. He's been holding out on you, Raymond. He's coming now.
And slow and steady wins the race.
He ain't giving him no signals or nothing. Where's those signals at, Raymond? Alright. Boy, he's got a ways to go to catch the leader, though. Here comes the second place running, number 61. That's Chris Kreider. And LeMaster, Josh LeMaster, moves and runs third. Wayne Ulrich is pulling off the racetrack. He's had enough. He said, it ain't running good enough, I'm pulling her in. Well, I'll tell you what. They need a yellow if they're going to try and catch this 42. 72, I'm sorry. 72. Probably pays something better than normal. couple bucks anyway. The master's there. What can he do? He's looking. Right up on the rear bumper of the number 61, but can't pull the trigger, not yet. Go. Now that leader needs to be careful with the last traffic. Okay, is Master going to get by the 61? That's what we're waiting to find out. Because if nothing happens, 72 is going to win this. Nothing bad happens to him. Knock on wood. We don't want to take... Coming around now, here comes your leader, and he's going to get the two-lap sign. 2 laps to go on the Predator 410. Hey, here's a serious bid, and it looks like the 9, but can he hold on to it? They were swapping paint going down the backstretch, and now the 9 has actually consummated that spot. He runs second. And begins to pull away. How about that? The master finally made the move. Well, 2 laps to go, he made the pass. Here comes the checkered flag, already taken by your winner, the 72. Finishing second was the master in the 9, and finishing third was the 61 of Chris Kreider. Well, fans, that just about wraps it up here for the Predator Cup. All 3 cups gone now. But we want to thank you drivers because you did a great job tonight keeping things going. I mean, I think it went real well. We got done and it's not even midnight yet. So we did pretty good. Shaved some time off things. Quarter after 11, 45 minutes earlier than last week. So I'm happy about that. Anyway, we thank you for coming out tonight. Want to thank all of our race officials here and Stacy Madigan for doing the video. We'll watch that this week. Tom Cat, my co-announcer here tonight working the grid. He said he's tired. He was on his feet here all day and all night. Don't forget next Saturday, August the 7th, will be TNC Trophy Night, Kids Night, including the favorite racer banner contest sponsored by Wiser Motorsports. Also next week will be return the Unlimited All-Stars. They're fun to watch. They're finally getting back here to Fence Creek. August the 14th is a regular show. Then on August the 21st will be a 50-lap, mark your calendars, $500 to win, Clone Clash for Clone 375. August 28th will be Twin 20s for Predator 410. So until next Saturday night, drive safe on your way home. We want to see you back here next week. Take care. Have a good week.